I was looking online for some different kind of effects and stuff to do for my painting because, I don't know, I just feel it needs more. So as you can see in the background, I've added foil on the bottom of one of the paintings so far. So I'm gonna do some foil art. Glued it on quite yet. Just a little bit of paint underneath to hold it in place. So, I had super glued the ends just a little bit. I've never done this before, so. To do the have a crackle effect, but I know you can use Elmer's glue and water. You know, if you don't have the actual crackle paint, but or the what's it called, the plaster. But just a little bit of purple came through here. I used some paint underneath the. I thought this was a neat alternative. Some narration for you, and I'll throw in some layered sounds with that, some foil and brushes for you. Now, like I said, I've never done this effect before, and I just started. Very hard not to tear. I'm always one for tearing things by accident. I'm not very delicate. Just want to get it done. Hold it. I've been sitting and looking at this painting in my living room for a few days now, and I just feel it just needs some more texture. I wasn't sure exactly where to put it, but I hope this turns out okay. It's definitely a very amateur video. So, I'll have to take this lengthwise. gently push down on it. Just push down gently on the side so I know where I want to put it. So right about there. So I actually don't have any glue, any proper glue. So I've been told I can just use some acrylic paint. This purple I won't be using a lot. Foil something to stick to, even just temporarily, so I have it all in place when I glue it properly on the edges. I'm very much like that when I get an idea, something to do, something to make. I always, always find a way, even if I don't have the proper tools. I can usually make it work. So it's not gonna look like much as I'm putting the foil in even the first couple days. I will try to track you through this process as much as I can. Just push down very gently. Got some purple paint on my fingers. Foil is actually something I have a hard time listening to, unless it's very gentle, and it's already been crinkled quite a bit. But I find it very hard on my ears. I'm just going to fold this over really quick, just to keep it in place. And we can do the next layer. So this painting took me about 8.5 hours. I have to say, 45 minutes of that, at least, was me staring. Not knowing what to do next, where to put my little Buddha. I'm very happy with how it turned out. Just gonna get some more foil now. I like how the foil will give almost a sense of like a rocky, desert-like kind of ground. Originally, I wasn't even going to color in this painting, but we need needs some color in her apartment, so I thought it'd be nice. There. Obviously, I'm gonna have to get some better glue. It's quite easy to work with, so. We will see. Dark umber, almost like the color of the branches, and some gold, and some bronze. All through this project so far, I've been running out of many things that I've needed. And sometimes less is more, but when it comes to paint and glue, I think I'm going to be needing to stock up on that. I'm saying that, I don't want too much foil on the side because I don't want it to stick out from the wall. Very sparkly. Here, I'll show you what it looks like. Once the whole project's done, I'm going to be putting a glaze on it. Nothing too shiny though, because our living room or our dining room and kitchen lights, when they reflect on the painting, you won't be able to see it very well. So I went ahead and I did the foil on the tree panel. A lot of this foil off so I can glue it down. There's the glue for model paint, model cars. I really want to do some painting for you guys. There we go. Push it all down. Make sure it's nice and tight around the edge without ripping it. It's not the heavy duty tin foil. Put a little bit in the corner here, just to make sure it doesn't fall off or anything. There we go. Kind of glad we went with the lighter canvases. We were gonna get some pretty big and thick ones. The glue on my hands. Okay. So, there's the third panel finished. Like I said, I was thinking of some browns and golds, some earthy tones. I'm gonna add some thinner. My paintbrush. It's called a filbert. I really like working with these ones. I did also buy some sea sponges, but the effect that they have. mixing up some paint over here to your right. I'll just show you. I'm just stirring it with the back of a paintbrush. I don't have very much paint to work with today. I really enjoyed painting the foil. It was definitely a different kind of feel, because normally when you're, you know, painting on a canvas, you know, the paint soaks in quite fast. So it had a different kind of feel to it. Paint went very far as well. I told you, it doesn't look like much. I hope I get the effect out of it that I want. But that's how you learn. Sometimes you just gotta Take an image you see in your mind and try and represent it. Certain aspects of it I do enjoy. Usually painting the background or doing the foil art is pretty fun. But I actually find I get quite stressed out because I have and I think it is a good way for us to really look inside ourselves and see and figure out why. Maybe we see the negative in things and how the negative can overcome, can overtake the positive. It almost makes me uncomfortable, like when it's in person. If someone sees something and really likes what I've made, I almost don't know what to do with that kind of feedback, I guess. And you look and you think, wow, that took a long time, but it was worth it. Done that a lot of times when I've drawn something or painted something that I really liked. And I took it just that one step too far. And then I didn't really like it as much. So I want to be careful. This is supposed to be going above our couch. I'm not gonna mix it in, I'm just gonna leave it as is and see what happens. Dab some gold in here, it looks really good. Oh, this is how I painted the whole thing. I had all of the canvases on just little TV trays, and I was crouched over them for over 8 hours. Oh my goodness, my back hurt after that. I think next time I will sit. I used to have an easel, but I find it hard to paint like that. I like painting from above to really get that. It's a different perspective.